Hey everyone, it's JTB back with another video in the Prima series. This is going to be chapters 4 and 5. Going on from here, the chapters get quite long, so I'm probably going to do maybe one video per chapter for the longer chapters. So we'll just jump in with chapter 4. It's pretty straightforward, so I'd be surprised if there's any really bad omissions here. It starts off with just the save statue, the first fight. Again, I'm not going to read every single snippet as it's just unnecessary, but again, it still doesn't tell you about any strings. It also does not mention that white commandos are one of the few enemies in the game that have no defense attribute. You know, you can just do whatever move you want on them and it will connect as long as you time it properly. That's not mentioned at all. That is a little bit technical, but it's something that's pretty obvious early on. You know, they never dodge or do anything basically. It doesn't mention their grab either yet, now that I think about it. So it tells you about the elixir, it tells you about the guillotine throw, which is really good. The guillotine throw is actually quite useful on normal. Okay, so it tells you about the forced fight. Does it mention the grenadier? So as you go into the other doorway extending the area, several foes will ambush you. Foes divide. Yeah, so it doesn't actually warn you about the grenadiers. The grenadiers are actually very, very dangerous. If their grenade hits you, unless you try and move immediately, they can just stunlock you over and over again with grenades. So it's very bad that it didn't say that. And also, if you go up to a grenadier, no matter what other enemies are on screen, they will drop their grenade launcher. And that turns them essentially into just a white commando guy with a little bit more health. You know, it just makes them significantly less threatening when they drop that grenade launcher. So through the gate, you've got another fight, pretty straightforward. It does tell you about the stone tablet, which is cool, even though you'd have to come back here anyway, so you wouldn't miss it, really. That's kind of impossible to miss if you're going to complete the game. So on your way back through, you'd have to deal with some more guys. Yeah, again, this is all white commando guys. This really is quite straightforward. It does tell you about the bow here, which is good. It does tell you about the hidden life of the gods to your right, which is also good. Does not tell you about the blue wire, though. In this screenshot here, you can see the blue wire, the blue cable. It doesn't tell you about that, which is very odd. There's a life of the thousand gods in there. That's a full life upgrade. Yep, that's just shimmying on the pipe. Yeah, drop to the street below. Yeah, so it doesn't actually tell you about the life of the thousand gods. That's an odd thing to miss out. I mean, you literally get the kunai scroll right there that tells you, you know, pay attention to stuff in blue. And there is a life upgrade right there. It does tell you about the nunchucks, which is good. They're actually much better on NGO4 just because of the counter-attack system. As you're around the first bend heading up the stairs, there's a squad of enemies laying in wait. This can be tricky due to the tight quarters. That is actually true. The commando guys really are a pain when you're really in close. Their grabs and their attacks have really good hitboxes, so you can kind of get pummeled there if you're not careful. Okay, so this is another ninja fight. Okay, so this is the first ninja encounter. This is the first Black Spider ninja encounter, so this will be interesting. As you exit onto the roof, a fearsome band of ninja equipped with explosive shuriken will accost you. If one of these hits you, immediately execute a wall attack, so you don't be there when... Okay, so it doesn't tell you about rolling through the incendiaries. These ninja are far and away your toughest opponents yet. Utilize your sense of reward to your advantage. Oh, wow, do they really just say, just, like, spam wall attacks there? That's terrible. The ninjas in air three-hit string can juggle you out of a wall run super easily, and then that sets them up for incendiaries. It doesn't tell you that you can just block and counter-attack the ninjas, which is a huge omission. A huge thing they fixed in NGB was they gave them a grab. I've talked about that recently on stream, but... the ninjas can't open you up if you just block. You can block their incendiaries, you can literally just counter-attack them to death. So it's weird that they didn't figure that out. Spirit of the Devils, cool. Muramasa. Okay, so no, make sure you have at least one weapon upgraded at this point. That's somewhat of a contradiction, because you only have one weapon that can be upgraded at this point. The Dragon Sword is the only weapon you have that can be upgraded. Unless you bought the wooden sword, but upgrading the wooden sword doesn't do anything until it's the UF, so that's a weird statement. Things are only going to get more challenging. You may also want to consider the Azuna drop. Also, you should definitely pick up the Azuna drop. There should be no also there. And same for Inferno. Nimpo is ridiculously overpowered in NGO4, so that should be, like, absolutely mandatory to pick up the Azuna drop in Inferno. That's cool. Tells you to drop off the scarabs. That's an important thing to not forget. I do that a lot. Back on the street. Okay, yes, we've got more commando guys. Again, it doesn't tell you about the black commando guys. The black commando guys have armor. They're the first enemy introduced that have armor. It didn't tell you that in Chapter 3, thinking about it. It doesn't also tell you about the proximity with guns and that. There's just a really, really basic stuff that... and I don't want to seem like I'm ragging on it too much, but I really feel like some of the stuff that I'm bringing up, if you are an action game fan, if you've played a lot of action games, this stuff you should just be noticing straight away. You know, you really should be picking up on these little things with enough experience. So there's just so much really basic info just not being conveyed here. In the shop after you finish, so that's the fight where the scarab is in the pond. That's the hidden chest. Okay, so it does tell you about this area, which is cool. Because you do get a nice amount of essence out of this chest. So that's just telling you how to flip up. Kill these guys. Yep, finds a chest with essence. That's good. I think there's like 4,800 in there. So that is actually really, really good. More ninjas. Yeah, so again, it doesn't tell you anything about the ninjas. You know, as you proceed into the fenced area, two more black ninja will come out. Slice into ribbons. If ninjas have... Again, ninjas are the first enemy introduced, the black spider ninjas, that have defense. They will evade your opening attack unless they're in recovery frames. You cannot just walk up to a ninja and hit them. It doesn't work like that. You don't have smoke bombs in this game. The fact that they haven't mentioned a single one of their strings, a single one of their tendencies, like whenever they roll, they're either going to do an incendiary or a string. It's just one or two guesses. The recovery on their incendiary throw is absolutely crazy. You know, you can be a roll jump distance away. They can toss an incendiary and you can get over there and launch them with forward Y. There's nothing like that mentioned either. So it hasn't really given you any information on how to actually fight ninjas. So this is just the platforming section. Diary, doesn't matter. Scarab, that's fine. Okay, so it does tell you about that. I was going to say, if they missed that, that'd be a huge blow up. We get to the save statue near Hans Bar. Another golden scarab. Okay, it tells you about this. Does it tell you about the windmill shuriken? You'll notice a QNS scroll that popped in mentioning a very powerful weapon. If you want to know more, go to the secret section. Okay, so we are going to do that. We are going to go to the secret section. Here we are. Windmill Shuriken. This massive... Okay, how to earn. Down the streets from Hans Bar, in a narrow alleyway, you'll have to use the narrow blue-striped area to venture into the back corner where this implement awaits. That's such a, like, really obvious option select that they probably couldn't figure out how to get it. Because that's not... that's not how you get it. You have to do, consecutive war runs to get it. It's not in the corner. It's really high up. In the corner's where the scarab is, not where the shuriken is. That's pretty funny. But that's pretty much exposed that they couldn't get it. because you would just put it here. Like, if they got it, it would be here. It would be right here where the scarab is. Why would you put that all the way at the end of... You know, this picture of Rachel is nice and all. It's great. You know, she's very pretty. But you could have just put that here on how to get the Windmill Shuriken. That's a bit silly. More ninjas. Again, more ninjas. No advice at all. I actually thought Chapter 4 was going to be like pretty straightforward, but Chapter 4 might actually be the worst one so far. The omission of like basic stuff on the commandos still at this point, the complete lack of any information on how to fight the ninjas, blatantly trying to option select that they couldn't get the Windmill Shuriken, and it's not in here. The Life of the Thousand Gods that they missed. I was actually expecting Chapter 4 would be pretty straightforward, but it might be the worst one. Okay, so Chapter 5, let's move on. Let's move on to something better. Okay, so we've got two maps. I don't really know why it's showing you these maps. It doesn't... You have the map in the... Like, these pictures are quite small. You know, I don't have anything here. Oh, yes, I do, actually. Here's some scale for you. An Altoids tin, there you go. Look how small these pictures are. You know, you can open this on your TV, you know, if you're playing on a nice big TV, you'll have a massive picture of the map. You don't really need these tiny pictures of it, which is a bit weird. Anyway, I digress. So we've got our Lily Key. I always forget to pick that up, so that's pro tip. And the save point. Drop down for the elixir, that's good. Yeah, it tells you to get the map. Again, more commandos. Again, no. I'm just going to start, like, skipping if there's no strings, because honestly, this is just gibberish, really. They don't actually give you any information here. Okay, so just tell you about the elixir. More guys, again, like, nothing. No strings or advice at all. As you exit the stairway, you'll spot an arcade machine. Okay, yeah, so we're not going to bother going ahead with that. Okay, cool, so it does tell you about the devil elixir. This fight... Yep, absolutely nothing. It also one thing that I think definitely confirms my suspicion that they didn't actually figure out the windmill shuriken thing is that it doesn't tell you to abuse Nimpo here, because if you had the windmill shuriken, you would be able to get to the Xbox machine, and that refills your Nimpo completely. So in these fights where it is actually tricky to fight the commandos, you could just Inferno these guys and refill your Nimpo for free. I'm going to try and remember if the Hans Bar machine is ever mentioned, because if not, that's probably something they had to contact the developer for. Like, what's this Kunai scroll about? Hugging the right way, so just go to the other key door. Again, this chapter's pretty straightforward. Here we are, so continuous war running. This is what you need to do to get the Windmill Shuriken. This should be here. This should be right here. It shouldn't be three pages technically. It shouldn't be 3 pages further on. It should be where you first need to do it to get the Windmill Shuriken and the Hans Bar machine. Again, so just more gibberish fighting the enemies. Okay, so now you'll come to a dead end with a ledge. From here, you'll have to execute the continuous war run for the first time. Not if you picked up the Windmill Shuriken. Mount the wall to the right, leap to the oncoming wall, then leap forward once more to clear the gate. Practice, however. Again, there's actually nothing in there regarding direction. Delete all this crap. And what you have to do is basically hold forward on the joystick. Let me get a controller here to aid the demonstration. So, if you have a controller like this, this very nice controller, if you do a continuous wall run, you need to be holding forward on the stick and then press A to jump. And then if you hold forward, Ryu will run, you know, in the direction along the wall. If you don't do that, if you just jump towards a wall, you'll just get a wall cling. You won't get a wall run. So they have neglected to mention, you know, jump forward while holding forward on the stick. Like, you have to keep the stick pressed in. If you let go of the stick, Ryu will just drop off the wall, and you then have to do it twice. So it's just forward, A, keep forward held in, and then press A again, and then you'll get the actual wall run technique. Much like the guillotine throw, that's just, you know, adequate at best description of how to do it. So, just tell you about the elixir. Another band of ninjas, I'm guessing there's, yep, after defeating them. Like, nothing. Absolutely nothing. Did it tell you to unlock that door? Okay, yeah, it does. That's cool, because that's just a handy little shortcut to have. Again, no strings, no information, no nothing there. Unless I missed it, let me just skip ahead here. There's not even an enemy section, is there? There's not even, like, an enemy tips section. Not that I can tell. I have a feeling this is only going to get worse, which is a shame. Okay, so get the key. You don't have to do a war run there. You can just jump straight to that scarab. But again, I wouldn't expect that at this point. Open the door. Go across the bridge. More ninja and absolutely nothing. I want to get a pen here and just, like, pencil in some strings. Just tell you about the scarab here. That's pretty easy to miss on your first time through. So that's good. And the elixir. I'm loving, cannot wait to get to how it tells you to fight fiends. So, yeah, commandos, more ninjas, doesn't tell you anything. Okay, so just before passing through the area, entering the annex, be sure that Ryu is full strength and ready for... Okay. They say that, and yet they're missing Nimpo and health. Again, they haven't got the Hans Bar machine. Right, so here's the fiend. So this is the first thing where I'm thinking this is probably going to be the start of things getting real bad. Interrupting your intimate encounter are several large red fiendish creatures. Immediately make your way to the wall. Any wall will do, and continue... Oh my god. Wow. Utilizing any Nimpo you have can also be a good idea. If the tide turns against Ryu, Perseverance will pay off. While it may not be the prettiest battle, it will eventually bear fruit. That's beyond awful advice. The Fiends, for anyone that knows, the easiest way to fight these guys is just one-on-one. You want to isolate them. You do not want... I mean, that screenshot right there, that person should be jumping the other way, should be moving away from the Fiends. Two Fiends like that, back-to-back, these guys are covered in armor. They will armor through your attacks constantly. Wall attacks have a huge amount of recovery on them. They can swipe you off the wall, they can chomp you, you can get hit off-screen with the roll attack they do. Again, this is awful. This is the first part where I'm probably not going to even try and sugarcoat it. This is just terrible advice. They don't describe any of the attacks. They don't really have that many attacks. You know, they have their fire breath, the two-hit swipe, and the chomp, their grab, and their roll attack. But that's only when you're far away from them. And their tail whip when you get behind them. As long as you dodge their attack and do a quick string like XXY or XYY, or you can even go for Blade of Nerida if you want, but if they do recover and grab, you can get hit. So for a new player, I wouldn't recommend that. I just keep it safe and keep it simple with Helm Splitter. Just do XYY, or if you want to be even safer, just do XXY and then roll away when they attack and then do it again. Roll away, do it again. Roll away, do it again. You'll be absolutely fine. It also doesn't mention that they're very prone to giving you health orbs. they are worth quite a lot of money. So, yeah, that's just awful advice. That's terrible. Let's just delete that. I just cannot get over that there is... That's almost a boss fight. It's like a mini boss fight your first time through the game. And there is not a single piece of actual information there. It's real bad. Okay, Hydrocubus. Let's hope it gets better. Let's get positive here. So, Fiend Behemoth, okay. Throughout this battle, keep Ryu in close and to his foe at all times. So this might appear suicidal, it's the safest option available. If you know what to do, yeah, I'd agree with that. But you do actually have to know quite a bit about Hydrocubus in order to stay near him and not get hit. Okay, so yep, that's correct, cutting away his tentacles. Forward. Okay, you don't want to use Helm Splitters. That's a terrible idea. Flying Swallow is definitely what you want to use here. Once it's mostly armless, move in and deliver the Blade of Nerida. That's fine. I mean, UTs are better, but, you know, you're invincible during a UT, and it's much easier to do. It's much easier to, you know, on a controller, much easier to just hold Y and let go than it is to do X, Y, X, X, X. So. He also does give you blue and reds. Oh, they do tell you about the acid thing. That's good. That's like the first legit tip that's in this guide, I think. Not to rag on it too much, but I think that's like the first good tip so far. If you do stay in close, the acid can't touch you. That's not too bad, actually. It's weird how Hydrocubus is probably the best boss so far, and yet immediately before it is by far the worst thing in the guide. So Hydrocubus is pretty decent. That's pretty straight. I mean, he is a pretty straightforward boss, but even so, it's better than what's come before it. Anyway, guys, that is going to do it for this one. We will carry on with Chapter 6 when we return. So far, this is definitely where I think it's starting to get bad. I thought Chapter 4 would be, like, really straightforward because it's a really simple chapter. But again, no information about ninjas, like, key items being missed. They missed the Windmill Shuriken. They don't tell you about the Life of the Thousand Gods. Chapter 5, again, no mention of the Hans Bar Machine. Their continuous wall running tip is rubbish. And the Fiend fight is just, you know, hot rubbish. Hydrocubus is fairly decent, though. That's about the only real positive thing I can say at this point. So I hope it gets better, but I'm losing hope, slowly but surely. So I hope you guys did enjoy this video. I hope it's not too negative. I don't like to rag on stuff too much, but I thought people just might enjoy this as, you know, take it with a pinch of salt, you know, because the odds are, you know, someone's not going to have the experience that I have when you make a guide like this. I guess, you know, it's just funny to look at it in hindsight. So I will catch you guys in the next video, which will be for Chapter 6. Take care.